Hey folks, Sirdar here, and in this episode of Dev with Sirdar, I'm going to show you how to create a Cython module that is part of a Python package that you're creating for redistribution. Now, when you create a Cython module that's meant to be redistributed as part of a Python package, you have two options for how to do this. First, you can distribute just the generated C source code from your Cython module and have the user compile the C source themselves. This is the easiest option for you, but it means whoever uses your module will need a C compiler. Option number two is to create a wheel. This is the format Python uses for redistributing packages, which can include compiled binaries. And so you can include a precompiled Cython module. The downside is that the wheels have to be built for specific versions of Python running on a specific platform. But I will show you how both of these things work because you can do them both at the same time. So here, I have a version of a sample project I've shown off a few times for my previous Cython demos. This is a Cython-powered version of Conway's Game of Life. This is a simulation of a colony of cells. And moving the performance-sensitive parts of this program into Cython gave it a massive speed boost. The simulation is running at something like 5,000 frames per second, thanks to Cython. I've only been running it slowly so you can see what it looks like. Now, if I disable the compiled Cython module and restart the code to run in pure Python mode, you'll notice the maximum frame rate has dropped to about 15 or 20 frames per second. So Cython is a big part of how this program works well, and we want others to enjoy that speed too. So I'm going to bundle my Cython components with this program for redistribution. Now, the layout for my repository for this program is following the most recent Python standards. There's a source directory, which has my program in it, a pyproject.toml file that describes the project's dependencies and behaviors, and a setup.py file to compile our Cython module. We have not yet reached a point in the Python tooling ecosystem where setup.py can be moved into pyproject.toml, so for now they have to remain separate files. The file in this repo that gets compiled to Cython is render.py, this one here. And inside, as you can see, I'm using this new Cython syntax that is much cleaner and easier to work with than the legacy syntax. It's called the pure Python mode syntax. I've done videos and articles about this before too. Now, the first thing that we need to do to build everything for distribution is to make sure that we have all of the additional packages we need. In pyproject.toml, I've listed those packages as development dependencies. One of them is Cython itself, of course, since we need that to build binaries for our wheel. The other is the build package. This is the most up-to-date tooling in the Python world for building wheels and source distributions from our code. Build is not included by default in Python since not everybody needs to build distribution packages, so we're going to install it as a dev dependency. And finally, we need setup tools since that's also instrumental for building our Cython module. I also have this section of the file here, which excludes the C source code generated from our Cython module from the binary wheel. It reduces the size of the wheel a little bit since the generated C source for a Cython module can be pretty big. But if you'd rather keep the generated C source in the wheel for reference, you can leave this part out. Note that the source distribution, which we'll also be building, will contain the C code. And that's actually a recommended practice for Cython because it means the person using the source version of the module doesn't need to install Cython to build your module. They just need setup tools and a C compiler. The next thing we want to do is give our setup.py file a look over. This should not be terribly extraordinary. There's just a couple of things here worth pointing out. One of them is that I'm using the recent Cython compilation options, chiefly the Cython limited API, which I've covered in a previous discussion of Cython. This allows the C code generated by Cython to be more compact and more efficient and more forward compatible. But it's still a very much under wraps kind of project, so we have to opt into it by using these lines here. This, again, is totally optional. Most people are not going to bother with this just yet. But with all that established, now we can build our package for distribution with our Cython module included. So to build both the wheel and the source distribution package, you only need to issue one command, py-m build. Now, the build process may take some time, because what build does is it creates a virtual environment of its own to install all its needed tooling into, also to install your particular package in, and to build all the code inside that environment as well. This way, you don't have the build process interfering with any existing virtual environment that you're using for development. And when the build process ends, this temporary virtual environment is cleaned up and removed. So once the build process concludes, you're going to see that you have a new dist directory in your source tree. Make sure that you don't already have one of these to begin with, by the way. And in there, you're going to see two files. One of them is your packages wheel, and the name of the wheel file describes which version of Python it's compatible with and what machine architecture. In this case, we have Python 3.11, Microsoft Windows, AMD 64. The other file is our source-only distribution, and that's packaged as a tar.gz file. The source version is a little larger because it contains the generated C code, and the generated C code is bigger than the compiled module generated from it, and not by a little bit either. Now, we can upload these to PyAPI, or we can install them directly using pip. And to demonstrate that, I'm going to switch to another virtual environment, which, as you can see right now, only has pip and setup tools in it. And in there, I'm going to use pip to install our binary wheel of this demo. And as you can see, once it's installed, it doesn't take very long. We can run it using the same command line that we used before, and there is no compiling required. We already have the binary components for this platform in the wheel. Now, I'm going to remove the wheel installed version using pip uninstall scilife, and I'm going to install the source only version. And the setup process for the source only version is going to take a little longer because the binary components have to be built using the C compiler on this platform, which is the MSVC suite. But once that's finished up, we've got the same high speed binary version as we did with the wheel. We just have to do the compilation process on this end. Now, one final note. If you're using source control like Git on your repository, and you really should be, do not include this distribution directory as part of your source control. There is no need to do it because these files are ephemeral. They get rebuilt as needed. They don't need to be change tracked. So to sum up, when you want to distribute a Cython module with a Python package, you can build platform and version specific binaries and distribute them as wheels. Or you can distribute a source only version and have the user compile the C code themselves. And to do both of these things, you use the build tool along with a properly laid out project file. So that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below. And don't forget to follow Dev with Serdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.